I've given the deck a few days to dry out, and it has dried out, and now it's ready to be sanded. But before we do that, we have to go around with the hammer and the nail set and make sure that all the nails are below the surface. If there's any that are protruding above the surface, it'll mess up the sander, and we don't want that. So you just go around and just drive the nails back in. And now this is my 5-inch sander, and it's great for jobs like this because you can actually get to each individual board, whereas if you have a big sander, it doesn't get to every board because the boards sit slightly higher or lower than one another. So this sander is great too because it has two pads here, one on the inside and then one on the outside. And then there's a space that's in between, and it allows them to oscillate independent of one another. Therefore, it cancels out a lot of the vibrations, so you don't get them all up your arm. And once again, whenever you pressure wash, it will loosen up the fibers of the wood, so you definitely have to sand. But the benefits of sanding are not only you get a smooth surface, but it actually opens up the pores of all the wood so that the stain or paint penetrates better into it, and it also creates a tooth for the paint or stain to adhere to too. So we're going to start over here and work our way to the left. So before we can start to stain, we have to rid the deck of all the dust and debris that was caused by the sanding. So we're going to use this blower here to get rid of it. This is great because it gets rid of all the dust from all the cracks and the crevices, which you have to get rid of, or else when you go to stain, the stain won't properly penetrate into the surface. So I'm just going to blow this deck off.